All right, let's talk. All right, we here. Come on, son, St. John 6 and 44. This is an attempt. I said to collect the debt. Tell America you are in debt. Isn't that right? Pay your fare. Pay your fare. Thank the Lord. They ain't combed their hair. Isn't that right? Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. This is St. John 6 and 44. Listen to the book.
No man can come to me
except
the Father which hath sent me draw him.
And tell him what he's going to do.
And I will raise him up at the last day.
Tell him what's written.
It is written in the prophets.
And they shall do what?
They shall be all taught of God.
Which means there should be some evidence and proof. Evidence and proof. And going back and just looking, because I get questions here and there periodically, people. I was talking about earlier, a gentleman that sent me an email. He's got to be a retard. I want to tell him I need to baptize all of you guys over because y'all been baptized in the name of Jesus. I need to baptize out of the name of Yeshua. And we need to use that name. I said, because you're a retard. You went to the website, got my email, so you didn't read anything. So you hadn't watched me to know anything. We stopped that years ago. So it's like, at what point do you keep being retarded? You know what I'm saying? At what point are he going to tell me? Also, he said, in case you didn't know, Jesus was the name of a slave ship. So I did want to inform y'all, let y'all know, we just learned that today. Due to his email he sent me today. That's retarded. You know, so many people, they're too retarded to even respond. I'm just too retarded to even respond to him. Then you got these other people still wrestling around with Yeshua being, well, Jesus being the devil. Now, that part is true. Jesus is the devil. Who else would take people on a slave ship? That's the devil. That's why they would name it Jesus, because they knew it was something they made up. And this is the thing we become to learn. People thinking I'm talking about the acts of Yeshua. When we use the name Jesus, we used it based upon thinking that was the name transliterated from the literal name, from the original name. We used it with the actions of the behavior that's associated. We didn't use it with Jesus the Son that worship. Jesus the pork rind eater. Y'all got me? When you look at the whole instance of how they even use the name and the characteristic, there ain't no salvation in that anyway. Y'all hear me? The importance of knowing the name is also knowing the real attributes and actions of the name. Y'all got me? If a person has of an honest, sincere factor of trying to be saved, it would make no sense that the Most High God wouldn't show you the right way. When the book said no good thing would the Lord hold back from them that walk up what? You walk up right, he got to reveal it to you. It's got to come. It makes no sense to still sit down in something and be totally ignorant. One thing we've always had to credit by the grace of the Most High, I've always had clean living. We've already taught that. One husband, we ain't get, oh, well, you know what? We ain't supposed to have no two and three wives. We ain't supposed to be having sex with kids. We're not supposed to be smoking and drinking. The whole premise of anything, first of all, you want to be a clean liver. What keeps a lot of these people in degradation so long? First of all, they ain't even clean liver. It don't make sense to give them a name. It don't make sense to even reveal to them away, because simply you ain't even living clean. Y'all got me? So when you start to go back to look at these people that study, say, well, you using that other people, but we had a behavior. This differentiates us from all these other people that go along saying we would have said we ain't never been the same. Even when using the name Jesus, you ain't never, we ain't never had the same mind. Now we come along and look at the people that gave it to us, gave us a lie. They gave us a book and they put lies in the book. So when you sit and you only limited to the book, you limited trying to know God. Just being honest. When you got a mind of looking and seeking and searching for truth, you're going to find, he said, they that thirst and hunger after righteousness, what did he say they going to happen? They're going to be fed. He got to do it to us. Who know how that works? Good, good. I deserve my paycheck then. Thank the Lord. Come on, son. Every man therefore that had heard
and hath learned of the Father
cometh what, son?
Unto me.
They're going to come unto me. That's St. John chapter 1 at verse 1. Only reason we go here, I had some questions. Got to try to help these people out. People still lost. People still going around. I don't know why these people have so many problems. I don't know why they keep going looking at the 14th chapter book of Isaiah and they keep coming up with Yeshua being the devil, and this is talking about the devil. It's no way it's talking about the devil, but you just keep doing stupid stuff. You got to sit around and get some teaching. That's why you need a teacher. There are behaviors that you pick up from the Old Testament, well, from our laws, that show you that this is him. Isn't that right? Let's see what he told. This is, give me St. John 7:38. Other brother, get me St. John 5:39. Then I want you to hold for me the 10th chapter of the book of Hebrews, Hebrews 10, and give me about verse 6. Hold that for me. That's up to them to remember. My teleprompter's getting a little rushed on me. Listen to the book.
St. John 7:38.
Listen.
He that believeth on me.
I want to St. John 7 and 1. We'll get that though. 7, I mean 1 and 1. St. John 1 and 1 too. But this is St. John 7, 38. Listen.
He that believeth on me,
as
the scripture hath said.
So when we look at the scripture, the only way to look at the scripture, then you got to go back to look at the law. Now he told us, in order for us to be saved, when we start out St. John 6 and 44, no man can come unto me except the Father which sent me draw him. I'll raise him up at the last day. Why did he tell us this? By the last day? I tell you, I declare the end at the beginning. I'm going to raise him up in the last day. It's written in the prophets. When you look at the prophet, then you got to go back to the Nineveh. When we go back to the Nineveh, which is going to be the prophets, which is going to contain our law as well, now right now, Kittavim. Now he's trying to let us know we got to go back and look at these things. Every man, therefore, that had heard and had learned. This is important because James told you, whose name will actually be Jacob, not James, Jacob, right? Same name as Jacob is the same as James. Y'all got me? So Jacob would have told us that be ye... But be ye doers of the word and not, see, because this is specified certain behaviors. A lot of us are saying, a lot of us are guilty of hearing, but you're not guilty of complying. You got me? So that's why he told you not just, you got to be ye doers of the word and not hearers only, singular. You can't just be a hearer and not a doer, because at that point, you're going to deceive your own self. This is what happened to a lot of our people. Oh, I heard that before. Oh, yeah, I've heard that. I've been told that before. What's key? You ain't obeying it. You, a lot of times you get people say, I've heard that before. I am not actually walking in it, but I know the information. So now we got to learn, as Jacob would have told us, we have to be doers of the word and not hearers only. This is what he was trying to tell her. Every man, therefore, that had heard and had learned, coming what? Because now there's going to be a regimen. There's going to be a practice of behavior once you learn something. Once something learned means you've been taught. If you've been taught something, you got to walk, you got to activate it. You got me? This is where a lot of people come short at. Now, St. John 7:38, he that believeth on me as?
The scripture hath said.
That's how you got to do it. What did the scripture say? Whatever the scripture, when we go to the Ninevehs, we go to the Kittavim, we have to believe on him as it said. Which means, what did it say? We have to be able to try to entail him into that situation. Isn't that right? We find factors that we can relate to that would correlate to him and identify him. He that believeth on me, as the scripture had
said,
out of his belly
shall flow rivers of living water.
That's going to be a constant stream, a constant running. But this spake he
of the Spirit,
which they that believe on him
should receive.
So if you don't even believe that he was, that, that when you read in the 14th chapter of the book of Isaiah concerning Lucifer, then you don't even have the Spirit.
Yeah.
Because the scripture said it. So you don't believe it. So you don't believe it. How did you get the Spirit? That's why it's so important to have a teacher, because things that people sit around in despair, they say, well, you just coming into it. The thing that we learn to come into, first of all, is practice of understanding how the book, the whole book is about him.
Amen.
So if the whole book is about him, it's up to us to read and get an understanding of where he fits into the book, where the whole book foretells him. The whole book is about him. When we read, we find characteristics about other people that relate to him. That's why he tried to let us know what you got to do. You're going to have to believe on me as the scripture had said, which means when I go back and read the scripture, there's not a lot of reading where I'm going to find the name Yeshua. When I find the name Yeshua, I'm going to find it concerning who they call Joshua. I'm going to find who they call Joshua, who's going to be the priest, the high priest. There's only a couple of times I'm going to find the name Joshua, Yeshua. So now when I go back to believe, it's not going to have to just, it can't just be the name. I got to look at characteristics. You got me? So when I go back into the law, I'm going to find characteristics. And when I find these characteristics, once I start watching his behavior, then I see it's talking about him. You got me? Now I have a characteristic with the name. The same way we knew the Most High. We knew characteristics before we knew the name. Hitherto my father work, and I do what? I do, before, when Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob had any contact with him, they never had a name, but they had a characteristic. When, even when our father, Jacob would have told him, whose name was Yisrael, changed by Israel, he said if God would bring him back into the place of my father, recognize, if he showed the same practice of behavior, he'll be my God. Now all I need is a name. Now we coming along, before you even get yourself tied up in the name, you need to know the characteristics that's associated with the name. Y'all got me? And this is what a lot of these people lack. Out of him better shall flow rivers of living water, but this spake he of the
Spirit,
which they that believe on him should
receive.
For the Ruach HaKodesh was not yet given,
because that Yeshua was not yet glorified.
He was not yet glorified. Mm. At the 14th chapter book of Isaiah. I'm sorry, Yeshayah. That's Y-E-S-H-A-Y-A-H. Who they call Isaiah, Yeshayah. That's right. Good deal, brother. The more we start to put into practice, the more we start to understand. Y'all got me? And we start to break away from the old center way tradition. Christian tradition is just bad altogether. It is bad. When you really look at it, how can I look at anything good as something that enslaved me? How can I find any, the book said no lies of the, what was it called?
Truth.
It's some truth in Jesus. It's a lie. It's a lie. It's not even transliterated. They lied to us. Mm. It's not even, it makes no sense. Listen to the book. This is 14 and 11. Listen.
Thy pomp is brought down to the grave.
Give me 14 and 1. Let's see what we're talking about.
Amen.
Come on.
For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob and will yet choose Israel.
Y'all hear that? The Lord is going to have mercy on our father. He said Jacob. And who else?
And
we say Jacob because there would have been a jail. They had a Y sign. Come on.
And will yet choose Israel.
And yet he's going to choose Israel.
And set them in their own land.
And going to set them in their own land.
And the strangers shall be joined with them, and they shall cleave to the house of Jacob.
Y'all hear that? And the strangers going to be do what?
Cleave.
They're going to cleave, which means what word will use him?
Levi.
Levi. They're going to Levi to us. And what is going to happen?
And the people shall take them and bring them to their place.
Did it make sense for us? It makes sense for us. Why? Huh? The people are going to cleave to him? We were already told they're going to take hold of the skirt of him that is of Yehuda. Because they have heard that God is with us. They're going to have to wind up joining to us. All these people going to have to at the end of the day. Yeshayah already told us this before. That they were going to do that. They're going to take hold of and even to our language. Isn't that right? The same thing that Zechariah would have told us. That these people are going to wind up taking hold to us. Because they've heard that God is with us. Come on.
And the house of Israel shall possess them in the land of the Lord for servants and for handmaids.
Come on, son.
And they shall take them captives, whose captives they were. And they shall rule over their oppressors.
Mm-hmm.
And it shall come to pass in the day that the Lord shall give thee rest from thy sorrow,
mm-hmm.
and from thy fear, and from the hard bondage wherein thou was made to serve.
Come on.
That thou shalt take up this proverb against the king of Babylon, say, how hath the oppressor ceased, the golden city ceased.
Come on.
The Lord hath broken the staff of the wicked.
Come on.
And the scepter of the rulers.
Come on.
He who smote the people in wrath with a continual stroke. He that ruled the nations in anger is persecuted, and none hindereth.
Come on.
The whole earth is at rest and is quiet. They break forth into singing. Yea, the fir trees rejoice at thee, and the cedars of Lebanon, saying, since thou art laid down, no feller is come up against us.
Come on.
Hell from beneath is moved for thee to meet thee at thy coming.
Y'all see that? The grave moved closer to you. Ain't no move for you. Come on.
It stirreth up the dead for thee.
It stir up the dead for thee.
Even all the chief ones of the earth.
You know what's amazing about this? When you hear this, when you start to listen to this, and without a teacher, they listen. King of Babylon is already struck in their mind. When you go back to read about these people, their actual events all entail him. Israel deliverance. Israel delivers Jacob, whom he named Israel later. When he talked about our freedom, our deliverance coming, it was going to come through the fall of a king. Yeshua was a king.
Amen.
This is why they had King of Babylon to fall. So when they saw him come on the scene and start seeing attributes, they understood that this king will have to fall in order for us to get our freedom. Y'all got me? Yep. When they came out to talk about us receiving the Spirit, he that believeth on me, as the scripture have said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. But this spake he of the Spirit, which they that believe in him should do what?
See.
Receive, for the royal heart condition was not yet given, because that Yeshua was not yet what?
Glorified.
Which means his glorification only came in fulfilling what the scripture said. All these people here, we talked, they were just an allegory. He was just an allegory. So Yisrael would have been looking, Jacob, now you're going to tie these people back into us. They would have looked at their delivery. They would have looked at their returning back after the fall of a king. Yeshua was king. Even when Pilate put him up, he put over scripture, behold, Yeshua, king of Yehuda. King of Yehuda. This is what they would have read. So it would have been with the fall of this king. Then he started to tell you how the grave came to meet you. It moved for you. Why is this important for us? Why would this? The grave came to move for him. That could be good too. Even when you look at, when you even start to look at when it came down to who bought his body. Joseph, a man of Arimathea. And because it was getting late, let's see what happened. At the 19th chapter of the book of St. John. Other one got me the 24th chapter of the book of Luke. We still deal with the 14th chapter of the book of Yeshayah. We had to say Isaiah sometime interchangeably because people watching, just like we did, we had to learn it. We had to learn. A lot of things are scary when things are new because you don't understand it. Just like with him coming on the scene, a lot of times we tend to kill and destroy things we don't understand. Y'all got me? That's what they did when they came along and saw. They didn't understand us. Stronger, bigger, better minded. The things that we did were had better conscience, had better moral and morality than these people ever seen. It only made sense to kill us. Kill us as soon as, like I told y'all before, think about it. Who gonna have a society where women walk around with their breasts out and a leaf on the front of their vagina and a man got a snow cone on the front of his genital and the folks ain't sitting around having sex with each other? Still got morality. These people got clothes on, they ain't got any. Fully dressed. How you think we turned the way we did because we got mixed in with them? He already told we can't. Think about it. Who should be the people that should have been the most whorish? Should have been the one with no clothes on. Yeah, they sell right here better dignity than we do. We got on drawers and t-shirts. Socks, every kind of protection you want to have on, and still we can't keep our sanctity. Still we can't keep no morality. These folks walk around with no shirts on, nothing on their butt cheeks, nothing. Everybody still sell right here steal the manufacturer and do the right thing. You won't even find in them tribes no homosexuals. You won't see two men walk around and say, "We ain't got nothing snow cone on the front of your journal. I got snow cone in front of mine. You ain't got nothing on your butt. I ain't got no mouth. We gonna be gay lovers." No Bible. No writers. And they got more morality than these people with education. These people ain't no position to talk to me. They ain't no position. You'll insult my intelligence to have a conversation with you. Everything we got wrong, we got from them. These people, they tell you ain't nothing but some barbarians in the woods of Africa got more morality than these people do with clothes on. It's got business suits and dry cars. They fly planes. They got aftershave lotion on. Got hand-molded shoe and sewn and handmade suits. All these people got leaves and straws. Baboon straw. Isn't that right? Eating monkeys and stuff. Still got more morality than these people. I ain't got no pedicure, no manicure. Still got more morality than these people. They ain't no position to talk to me. Tell them to bring me the best one they got and let me sit down and talk to them. With their suit on, I said, "You still a nigga. You still a nigga. You get them just tell the truth. Every one of you just run till you repent. The black nation too, just run till you repent." Come on, son.
St. John 19.
Hey, give me about verse 36. Listen.
"For these things were done that the scripture should be fulfilled.
Come on.
A bone of him shall not be broken."
Come on.
"And again another scripture saith, they shall look on him whom they pierced."
Come on.
"And after this, Joseph of Arimathea, being a disciple of Yeshua."
What happened?
"But secretly for fear of the Yehunans."
Yeah.
"Besought Pilate that he might take away the body of Yeshua."
Come on, son.
"And Pilate gave him leave."
What happened?
"He came therefore and took the body of Yeshua."
What happened?
"And there came also Nicodemus, which at the first came to Yeshua by night."
Come on.
"And brought a mixture of myrrh and aloes."
Yeah.
"About 100-pound weight."
Come on.
"Then took they the body of Yeshua."
Uh-huh.
"And wound it in linen clothes."
And did what?
"With the spices, as the manner of the Yehudans is to bury."
Come on.
"Now in the place where he was crucified, there was a garden."
In the place what?
"Where he was crucified."
There was a what?
"Garden."
What happened?
"And in the garden, a new sepulchre, wherein was never man yet laid."
Yeah.
"There laid they Yeshua, therefore, because of the Yehudans' preparation day."
Yes.
"For the sepulchre was nigh at hand."
See that? I had to get somewhere close. I had to set it up. When they killed him, they could have took him out somewhere a long distance. He said, came to meet you. He died in a garden of a man having to come up and beg and unbought the body of him. And when he got it, I just so happened, I got a place right here you could bury him. Yeah. Yeah. And it wound up working out because now our feast was coming up. Yeah. And this is closer. He said, so I made the grave come and meet you. These folks don't know they're doing it, read their book. He told the grave done came to meet him. How you going to get more convenient than that?
Man.
Here it is, you get soon they take you down. It just happened to be one right here, boss.
That's right.
But these people don't know. You know what? I ain't even read it before I went to it. That's what I do for a living. These people don't know what they're doing with their book. He said, man, the grave done came to meet you. It done came closer for you. These stupid people don't see how their book talking about him. So when you read, what would be the importance hey, of telling me about a grave being right there while he was crucified? It don't have no bearing on my salvation, does it? Yes, it does, because I got to believe at the scripture I've said.
That's right.
I was supposed to know and saw this. This is just amazing. This man wound up being a king, and a king was supposed to fall to get our deliverance. This just wound up being amazing that the grave going to come closer to meet him, and sooner we take him down, it just happened to be close to where a grave had to be close to where he's been crucified at. I need to know. If you ain't need to know, it wouldn't be in there.
That's right.
Amen. These dumb Christians don't know what they're doing. Y'all can't for let none of you trouble me. These folks are wasting my time. They read a book, they don't even know what they're doing. Tell me when the dead ever been stirred up for the king of Babylon. At the 27th chapter of the book of Matthew. These people don't know what they're doing with their book, they. That's right, Matthew, y'all. Appreciate you. Y'all mess around, man. Solomon don't show out on y'all in here now. Brother Darren, you were with him on that yesterday, y'all, though, weren't you? You was on with that one, too. Who else was with you? Bishop Jaheed. That's right. Did y'all remember that? Matthew, y'all. That's his Hebrew name. I got to tell them, too, his name was not no Peter. They ain't no name no petrol. That's the gas station. Don't take no gas station name after no apostle. Cephas is actually Aramaic. That's an Aramaic name for the stone. That's not Hebrew. It's Aramaic. You need to know that. Y'all got me? Cephas is what he named him. Simon is also a Greek name. His name would have been Shimon. Oh, I think it's S-H-M-O-N. A lot of times you might spell it S-H-I-M-O-N. And the reason you'll put these I's and these E's is because of English discipline for pronunciation. We're going to put letters that sound like. Hebrew would never use vowels and consonants. This is stuff we got from these people.
Yep.
Stop trying to take your English discipline and put it on Hebrew or Hebraic words. Before a vowel, before a consonant ever came, the Hebrews had our own writing. We had our own language. Y'all got me? Of course, we would know Aramaic and Hebrew would be our languages. Right? We've been in captive. We came out. For our forefathers, we were Aramaic. Before we ever came out to be Hebrews. We'd have spoke Aramaic. We'd have dealt with the Egyptians. Y'all got me? There's Bible proof of us speaking Aramaic. Let's see. Oh, goodness. 2 Kings chapter 18. Let's see if I got rusted. Word right, though.
Amen.
Let me see what 18:14 say. Might have to read down, but it's the same word. Listen to the book.
And Hezekiah, king of Judah, sent to the king of Assyria, to Lachish, saying, I have offended.
Come on.
Return from me. That which thou puttest on me will I bear.
Come on.
And the king of Assyria appointed unto Hezekiah, king of Judah, 300 talents of silver and 30 talents of gold.
Come on.
And Hezekiah gave him all the silver that was found in the house of the Lord.
Come on.
And in the treasures of the king's house.
Mm-hmm.
At that time did Hezekiah cut off the gold from the doors of the temple of the Lord.
Come on.
And from the pillars which Hezekiah, king of Judah, had overlaid.
Come on.
And gave it to the king of Assyria.
Come on.
And the king of Assyria sent Tartan and Rabsaris and Rabshakeh from Lachish to King Hezekiah with a great host against Jerusalem.
Come on.
And they went up and came to Jerusalem. And when they were come up, they came and stood by the conduit of the upper pool, which is in the
what
highway.
What verse I want, 28? 26. Jump down to 22.
Amen.
Come on.
But if ye say unto me, we trust in the Lord our God.
Yes.
Is not that he whose high places and whose altars Hezekiah hath taken away?
Come on.
And hath said to Judah and Jerusalem, ye shall worship before this altar in Jerusalem.
Come on.
Now therefore I pray thee, give pledges to my lord, the king of Assyria.
Yes.
And I will deliver thee 2,000 horses.
Come on.
If thou be able on thy part to set riders upon them.
Come on.
How then wilt thou turn away the face of one captain of the least of my master's servants?
Come on.
And put thy trust on Egypt for chariots and for horsemen.
Come on.
Am I now come up without the Lord against this place to destroy it?
Mm-hmm.
The Lord said to me, go up against this land and destroy it.
Come on.
Then said Eliakim, the son of Hilkiah, and Shebnah, and Yor, and Rabshakeh, speak, I pray thee, to thy servants.
Speak who?
I pray thee to thy servants.
I ask thee thy servant. How?
In the Syrian language.
In the Aramaic language. Listen why. And listen what they wanted.
For we understand it.
Undo what?
And talk not with us in the Yehudans' language.
We don't want to talk to you like that. Told her to talk to us just like we talk to these people. Just talk to us in English. We understand it. Y'all hear me? So they just told them, we speak Aramaic. We understand Aramaic. Y'all got me? We understand it. Are y'all all right?
Amen.
So it would make sense even when you come along, he would name him after Aramaic name. We did know Aramaic. That would have been our first language. Y'all got me? Come on, sign back to what you had. At the 27th chapter of the book of Matthew.
Amen.
Matthew chapter 27, about 62. Thank the Lord. We try to get us understanding. Unlike these other people, they keep running around and just complete being oblivious and just being an idiot when you ain't got to be an idiot. Not when understanding comes. Y'all hear me? Man, people all over the world watching us. These people know they got to get it. These folks know they've been led wrong too long. Ain't that right? Time for us to know the truth. Listen to the book.
62?
62. 61 will be fine. This is St. John. I'm sorry. This is Matthew chapter 27 at verse 60. Come on.
And laid it in his own new tomb.
And laid him in his own new tomb.
Which he had hewn out in the rock.
Listen.
And he rolled a great stone to the door of the sepulcher.
Uh-huh.
And departed.
Come on.
And there was Mary Magdalene.
Back me up at verse 56.
52?
57. Let's see what that says.
When the even was come,
uh-huh,
there came a rich man of Arimathea named Joseph, who
yeah,
also...
Bad me up. 52. Come on.
And the graves were open.
And the who?
The graves were open.
51.
And behold,
yes,
the veil of the temple was rent.
And what else happened, son?
In twain from the top to the bottom.
Yes.
And the earth did quake.
And the earth did shake.
And the rocks rent.
And the rocks rent.
And the graves were open. And many bodies of the saints which slept arose.
So explain to me from the 14th chapter of the book of from Yeshayah, how you going to come up with this on the king of Babylon? Explain to me when the king of Babylon died, he woke up the dead. Explain to me how the grave came to meet him. Hmm. That's all they got to do, explain it to me. So they want to go to the king of Babylon. I know what they say. Only when we went here, because they all think they're so darn smart, I'm the one stupid. He never go up. You're a retard. Everyone, you're retarded. You sit around, you fight the truth. Just explain me when the king of Babylon did it. That's all they got to do. I can show you where he did it. He told me to search the scripture. In them, pick me up at 5:39, St. John. These people don't know what they're doing with this book. I told them before they ought to be arrested. It's bad. I can tell you, their translation, that they sat here and put errors in, I can correct and still show these people don't even know what they believe. That show you know you're a hypocrite. How you going to write something, and you don't even believe it? You going to write something, I said, dang, you wrote, I don't believe it. You know that make you a stupid fool. Why did you write it you don't believe it? This is their book, Leon. We didn't come here with this book. You had this book on the Santa and the Pinta, or the penis, because we got screwed on that boat.
That's right.
Isn't that right? The Mayflower. No, they were gay. Oh, what, man? Look at the flower. I christen you the Mayflower. No, they were gay. Look at a man name. Ship the ship. Pimp ship something. No, ain't no penis. Isn't that right? No Santa Maria. What in the world are we doing this stuff? Spanish names. Folks, they didn't splat it. They putting us right back. Everything we got Spanish on it. All our killing, we had that is capped. I ain't speaking that junk no more. I did my laugh for at least $40. Don't sit around and say they want to the Mexican, don't even know they've been enslaved. Yep. You ain't even original people. You ain't nothing but mixed with Spaniards and stole with some Indians. Made a fool. You ain't even real people. Mexicans are not original people. They are mixed race. You are hybrid. I know you something getting mad at me, it's just the truth. You're a hybrid. None of these people, you can't just make a Mexican with a Mexican. A Mexican is a hybrid. You got to take a Spaniard and an Indian and put them together to make a Mexican. Which means, why you sitting around, you hating, and they got Black gangs and Mexican fighting each other. You don't need to be fighting me. I don't need to be fighting you. I ain't got no problem with you. I said you ought to take everything that belong to you, because I'm going to take what belong to me. Ain't that right? I'm just like Jephthah. You got time. Whatever belong to you, you need to take it, because whatever our God give us, I ain't getting it back. And that's what our great leader Jephthah said. I'm not giving up nothing. Y'all hear me? So whatever they can take and get belong to y'all, you need to get it. Y'all got it. Better get it, because whatever our God get up, we taking that. That bad, man. We got folks sitting around, they thinking they're an original people. They on history show. You not know you a hybrid. Why in the world you sitting around hating me a hybrid? I'm the only original thing that country ever seen. They ain't got nothing on their planet more original. Even white people done came from being black. When they die, show me one of them stay white. I want to see that magic trick. I'm going to leave the casket. I'm going to just sit there and watch you for days. And you're going to be just like Uncle Rugger. Every day your skin going to get black and black. Everybody go black. Yeah. You know, you everybody on the planet is a hybrid except for us.
Yeah.
The original man on this planet was black. Nobody talk about this stuff. I ain't arguing with these people and all these people break-offs from break-offs. Man, y'all break-offs. Y'all all right. Amen. Who tell us this stuff? Amen. We sit around these folks got our program thinking we some type of hybrid. We ain't no hybrid. We the original people.
Right.
Listen, our DNA so strong, you can take a white baby and he can be white. If he got a drop of black of blood, he's considered black.
Yeah.
He cannot put down white. You know what you can do with a black baby that got white in it? He can put black on them.
Yep.
With white blood, he gonna put black jet dominant. Let me take some paint. Let me take some white paint and put some black in it. Why we having that white paint? Huh? You pour that white in that black, you ain't finna make black white. You just ain't finna do it. Isn't that right? You gonna be pouring a lot of black. You not finna make no black white. And you take white and try to pour over black, you know what black do? Bleed through the white. They took this white paid right here, and they done tried to put them lies about this white man. You know how? He done bled through.
That's right.
He wound up bleeding through. Yeah. Is that better? He like, we bleed through. Yeah. What did they tell? The man was white, didn't he? Yeah. They painted him white. Black bleed through. Black hard to cover. Yeah. Y'all know the hardest color to paint on the car? Black. Yeah. It's the hardest color. Any other color you can put on the car, black. You ask anybody paint, black is the hardest color to paint. There's something unique about black. Y'all hear me? When black come, we take over, we make night. When we get it, you can see we rule. Y'all all right? Amen. Then they done got us hating ourselves, trying to run the light. Black gonna rule. Y'all hear me? All right, listen to the book.
St. John 5:39.
Listen, search the what, Brandon?
Scriptures.
The scripture, that's gonna be our law. Search the scripture. For what way he want me to search the scripture? This red right, ain't it, Brandon?
Amen.
Who they call Jesus, who we know his name is Yeshua. You follow Jesus, I don't even tell what that name. You know Jesus says, I don't have no own. Jesus said man can be gay. I ain't gonna argue that. Why would I argue Jesus said a man can be gay? I'm sure he did. Jesus said Taco Bell still at 1 o'clock. Of course he did. Hey, Sue, know what time they open and close? Isn't that right? I ain't gonna argue, but I know what Yeshua said. I ain't gonna argue about nothing Jesus said. That'd be a stupid argument. Jesus said all kind of stuff. And ain't said stuff. You come to Yeshua, I can argue with that. I'm like Paul, I'm in defense of the gospel. Listen to the book.
For
search
in
the
them,
scripture. For in them you think you have what?
Eternal life.
And, but what I got in them?
And they are they which testify of me.
So when I read the 14th chapter of the book of Yeshua, he said testifying to him. Because I can't find where the king of Babylon that had the grave to get closer to him. I can't find where he done woke up. Even if the grave got closer because he was an allegory, I ain't going to find where he raised no dead up. He said, you done stirred up the dead. They're talking about him. Come on, son, back to the 14th chapter of the book of Yeshua. These people don't know what they're doing. He sent me questions, email about stuff. Don't argue. You want to know? Let me teach you. Don't be trying to send me no script. You ain't showing me nothing new. All you're gonna be doing is error. You're a female. You ain't got, I ain't know. I'm like, come on, you're a female. You can't show. This is error.
Amen.
You can't be no daughter, Abraham. You trying to show me no scripture? Ain't no way the Most High God gonna be with you. That's an error. Y'all just stop it. Amen. Come Come on, 14. What verse we at?
At verse 9.
At verse 9. Come on, son.
Hell from beneath is moved for thee.
What else, son?
To meet thee at thy coming.
See, they see hell first thing they associate with fire. That's what they look at. He said, meet you at your, because he was getting ready to die, which meant I made the grave get closer. They so dumb, they don't even read that. The only reason John didn't record it, man, when he wrote it, recorded that it was cold, because he had to fulfill the scripture. Now, if you read it, all you came up with, Babylon, the king of Babylon, he don't let you know you ain't got no eternal life. Because they're talking about me. It's talking about me. All their preparations were made for me. Listen.
It stirred up the dead for thee.
Look at it. It stirred up the dead for you. Come on, son.
Even all the chief ones of the earth.
Listen.
It hath raised up from their thrones all the kings of the nations.
Lord, have mercy. Come on, son.
All they shall speak and say unto thee,
yeah,
art thou also become weak as we?
Come on.
Art thou become like unto us?
You see that? You done came like unto us. Because he going to wind up dying. Y'all hear me? He done became just like unto them. Y'all got me? Which made sense for us because he'd already told about our law. What did he tell us in our law he was going to wind up doing? He going to do what? He took part of the same. What did he tell you he going to do? At the 26th chapter of the book of Leviticus. I'm waiting. Huh? Vayikra. V-A-Y-I-R-A. I'm sorry, Y-I-Q-R-A. Vayikra. Which actually would be spelled V, accent. The only reason you're getting these A's and these E's is because of English discipline. They're using vowel. That's why they're going to put the V-A. It's actually going to be V, accent, Y-I-Q. R-A. Vayikra. What does it mean? Called. He called. And guess what? I just called this book for you. He called it. Y'all hear me? That's what it means, but he called. Listen.
Chapter 26.
At verse 10. Listen.
And ye shall eat old store.
Because of what?
And bring forth the old because of the new.
See, that's why we gonna do it. Come on.
And I will set my tabernacle among you.
I'm going to set my tabernacle. This is what we look at concerning him. He told us our tabernacle is a dwelling. When he told us he was going to set his tabernacle among us, we should have paid attention to this. Y'all got me? Hold you guys at the second chapter of the book of St. John, 2 and 19. Man, I need some time. I know I got to get y'all out of here. This thing ain't right. These folks sitting around be questioning me, thinking they be smarter than me. No, I don't know everything, but I know enough I ain't stupid. Y'all hear me? And I ain't got no pride, well, I won't make no changes. Y'all know that or no. We done changed it. We done did what we had to do. We were going to get rid of synagogue. Find out synagogue and temple Greek. Even house. House is not, that's Dutch.
Yep.
Bethel. You ain't, some words you ain't going to get around. But this is the thing, what you look at, how you know it right for us. You'll never find a Greek in a synagogue. Notice what you don't ever, this is how people don't pay attention. You never find them writing where Greek, they put it there by mistake saying they was in synagogues too. Or a temple, they ain't gonna do it. They gonna go to use what they want. They know it's a church. See how you can see the difference? If they would have had Greek synagogue, then it's questionable. Y'all see what I'm saying? That's what we learning. Lord, listen, there's no way you got these people languages. Even when we converted over to mean Hebrews, we were gonna still carry some Aramaic words. In the fourth chapter of the book of Galatians, he told us, with spirit requires that you saying what? Abba Aramaic. It means father. Coming from who else we look at? Abraham. Abba means father. That's why his name shorted for that Abba. It means father. Y'all got me? Yeah. The Ham was father of many nations. Then Abraham came in. Abram is what we would have called him at first. Would have been father of many nations. Abraham meaning exalted father. So when Isaiah came and told him he going to be called the everlasting father, that's why he had to be exalted.
Amen.
The Lord told her concerning the Lord, he said he's going to be extolled. He's going to be highly exalted. So we looked and realized the book was talking about him. The father going to be of many nations. The exalted father.
Amen.
That all referred back to him. That's why Yeshua told us. He's going to be the everlasting father.
Amen.
Everything come back to him. Everything relate to him. Listen.
Yeshua answered and said unto them, destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up.
Listen.
Then said the Yehudims, 46 years was this temple in building.
46 years was this temple in building.
And wilt thou rear it up in 3 days?
What happened, son?
But he spake of the temple of his body.
So he said he's going to put his tabernacle in the midst of us. What was he talking about? He was talking about his body. He was talking about his body. Ain't that right? This is where he was talking about his body. Now he came along and told us they can destroy this temple or this tabernacle. And in 3 days, I'll build it back. They looked at how long it took them to build that natural temple. Then he said they understood not. He was talking about his body. Back to the 26th chapter of the book of Vayikra. Vayikra. Leviticus, for those of y'all listening in. Man, we're going to get y'all doing real well. Little by little, we come into the knowledge of it. Start to put it into play. 26, and where you at? Verse 10?
Verse 11.
Listen.
And I will set my tabernacle among you.
I'm going to set my tabernacle among you.
And my soul shall not abhor you.
And my soul shall not hate you.
And I will walk among you.
I'm going to walk among you.
And will be your God.
And what happened?
And ye shall be my people.
That's why you'd have found Thomas, who would have stuck his hand inside and said, my Lord and my who? I told you who I'm going to be. I'm going to walk in the midst of you. What prophet going to tell you he's going to put his tabernacle in the midst of us, and then he's going to be walking? Where he going to be walking at? In the tabernacle. I'm going to be inside the flesh. These people don't know what they're doing. They have no idea what they're doing with this book. The only reason it came along and told you about destroying the temple, those that would have knew the word and would have understood, like the book told us in the book of Zechariah, they knew it was the Lord. We knew it was the Lord. Who else could it be? That's St. John chapter 1, verse 14. We'll come into the 14th chapter of the book of Yeshua, which is Isaiah for those watching, listening in. He said, the only thing about him, he be teaching, he just be calling people stupid. I don't call everybody stupid. I just call stupid people stupid. Don't make sense to call everybody stupid. That don't make sense. Everybody ain't stupid. Who's stupid? Stupid people stupid. Stupid means you're a fool. You're a fool if you sit here and you know and you don't do it. What else you going to do? Where else you going to be? And Yeshua told you that in the 25th chapter, 24th chapter book of Luke at verse 25. Old fools are slow of heart to believe all the prophets have spoken. Are not the Messiah that suffered these and they enter where? Into his glory and beginning at who? And Moshe and all the who? Which would have been the Nineveh. He has found on them in all the who? That's going to be all the scriptures, which is going to be the Nineveh, the prophet, and it's going to be the Kitavim, which is going to be your writings, remember? All the scripture, the things concerning who? There's no way in the world he's going to tell me by themselves and go through all the scripture. He's going to say, get paired right here. Yes, you got the 14th chapter, which it wouldn't have had no number. That would have been added later, those chapters. It's just been the book. It made no sense. He'd have went and said, oh, skip pad this. This ain't talking about me. Skip, what it look like? You're probably going through all the scriptures, finding things concerning you, which means you got to go through the whole book.
Amen.
He done went through the Nineveh. He done found all the scriptures. He got right here, he could explain that. This not talking about me. This talking about the king of Babylon. Y'all got to stop being so, I tell him what he said. Why y'all sit around arguing with me like y'all some kind of stupid fool? Folks, this is the book. I ain't write this. Come on, son.
At verse 14.
Come on.
And the word was made flesh.
And the word was what?
Made flesh.
The word was made what?
Flesh.
And what did it do, son?
Dwelt among us.
I don't know what that means, Dave. Yeah. I'm going to set my tabernacle in the midst of you. I'm going to walk among you. What could that possibly mean when I come here and read the book of John and he sit here and tell me, the word was made flesh, which means tabernacle, temple, and dwelt among them. He just finna tell you in the book of Vayikra that he was going to say here, he was going to dwell among you. I'm going to walk among you. That's why he said and told you in the book of Luke how he got to walk today and tomorrow. He had to fulfill with the book. So he said, I'm going to walk among you. Why did he come along and tell us in that book that he was going to walk among us? Come on, son. That's the 13th chapter book of Luke right quick. Say that what I want. 13:23. That's right, Doc. He was a physician. Who need a physician? We sick, boss. We sick. I thank the Lord ain't the only one teacher.
Amen.
Appreciate bodies now opening it up for them by bringing them bodies in there. Folk don't have to believe it. They ain't have no dead bodies in no temple. That's how you defy the house. We got all that cut. That's why you know ain't no God never been in what they had. Now we sitting in them church for maldehyde, dead bodies, all that junk in there, cutting the done food. Said I have a servant then, telling them folk going home to God. God don't live in no ground. Man, we taught all them lies. These folks, they taught us lies. That's how they had to do that to feel good about themselves and their forefathers. Rapers, murderers, molesters, gone with God. Nothing but lies. The book done told it in the book of Yeshayah, the 28th chapter, they made lies they refuge. On the falsehood, they hid themselves. Come on, son.
Then said one unto him, Lord, are there a few that be saved?
Come on, son.
And he said unto them, strive to enter in at the straight gate.
Yeah.
For many, I say unto you, will seek to enter in and shall not be able.
Come on.
When once the master of the house is risen up and hath shut to the door, and ye begin to stand without and to knock at the door, saying, Lord, Lord, open unto us.
Yeah.
And he shall answer and say unto you, I know you not whence ye are. Then shall ye begin to say, we have eaten and drunk in thy presence.
Yeah.
And thou hast taught in our streets.
Yeah.
But he shall say, I tell you, I know you not whence ye are.
Yeah.
Depart from me, all ye workers of iniquity.
So I told you before about being a doer and not a hearer only. They said you taught in our street. They said we obeyed. These folk, the only reason the Most High God set up myself and other true preachers in these folks' sight, they got to hear it. Even these folk, they're going to be without. You didn't hear them say, we didn't know, nobody never told us. They testified themselves saying, we heard it. You taught it in our street. Lord, none of you did internet. Ain't no telling how many folk done crossed on up. Professional to bums. To even little kids can pull up on YouTube and get it. Yeah. And the day of judgment, all these folk going to stop. They ain't going to be able to tell that lie. You done heard the word.
Amen.
This word going to come and going to judgment. Like, why y'all think these folk making their way ahead to get him? They see the time closing. Man, gap getting smaller and smaller. They getting tighter and tighter. Ain't no cover to cover. These folks say this thing ending up. They going to have to come to God. Everything, London Bridge is falling down. They already told y'all when they come down there, Greek, when the Greek done fail, the way the Greeks are falling, they're going to mess up y'all economy. The Italians, I tell y'all one, the Italian company, Italian, the country, is our number one trade. All that attached to Greece. Y'all hear me? All this stuff attached. We mean these folks done put their whole hope in these people. They got to fall. We're going to put you right back at the Vatican. All these folks do more trade with the Vatican, their rotten country, than they do with the people of God. Y'all hear me? They had to fall down. Every country that done rose up against a God, bringing them down. Look at Babylon, Iraq, down. Every one of these countries, down. Look at Greece, down. Every one of these countries took a cat, God taking them down. Look at Syria. Don't we been up on these folks to Syria? Look at them, down. They falling down. Country been taken, bummed. 63 million people done had to been there play in a year, kicked out. I said, thank the Lord.
Amen.
Thank the Lord. I'm praying for God to keep your economy stricken.
Amen.
People sitting in front of the tiller machine. We were the tiller years ago. They don't know they did it. Y'all holler, anything I call it the tiller. You the wall, you had a picture of a white one with red cheek. One, it was the tiller. I remember when drive through first owner, you to give kids suckers. They gave it to us because they done took our money. We ain't getting it back. Come on, here you go, sucker. What color sucker?
God.
Now they get, years ago, they used to give you that. You go to drive through, they look how many kids in the car. Your nigga face all up on the woman. Make sure don't forget you in there either. Then you be scrapping for them done sucker car. No, you a nigga, no matter what color. You didn't want something because somebody else got it. Yeah. Care what color, you get it free, nigga. Yeah. Isn't that right? Free sucker, you cutting the food like you paid for something. That's my red one. You ain't paid for nothing, nigga. They gave it to you. But then again, you did pay when you put your money in that bank. Y'all all right? See, we own up and expose these people. They've been exposed. Everybody done took us captive, God. Look at Egypt. Egypt done changed president at least three times. The Muslim Brotherhood came to them, and they got taken down. They got another rotten leader. Then Barack, who had the first, he in prison. Every one of these people done took us captive, God, taking them down. We just got one more. We ain't got but one more. Yeah, watch the movie Bloodsport. When John Claude done pulled up, okay, USA. All these people took us captive, got to pay. Isn't that right? I ain't going to be upset when God pay you back.
Amen.
God got to render her reward.
Yep.
Y'all know that? All of them, look, how everybody done failed by they don't get there. They got to get yours. You telling me he done took down Greece, he done took down Egypt, he done took down Babylon, and you guys going to be left standing? That don't even make sense. That don't make sense. He going to leave you standing. Then, you know what? I went to the hotel today to pay for a hotel for somebody today. Went and got this nice piece of paperwork. Starting today, they just instituted a 5% increase on your gas in Georgia and on your hotel stays. Started today, effective today, you just got 5% more at your gas pump coming. You think they did that to an economy that's striving and recovering? They did it to an economy that's hurting. They did it to an economy that they put lies and told lies behind, and they fall and they got to steal some more money. Oh, they're going to keep pumping money to Greece, and I love it. I hope they give them another $270 billion. All them crackhead niggas mess up. They can't ever recover. One God put their hand against you. Anybody can bring you up. You think I'm going to pray for them? Not according to Jeremiah 14 chapter. I won't pray not at all for these people, not for their good.
Amen.
And when they pray and they make fast, God ain't going to hear them. You're in bad shape. God ain't got, this is what y'all don't understand. If you ain't on the man of God heart and mind, who praying for you? When God done set the man of God to come against you, just like when the man of God woman cried against the altar, ain't no good going to happen to you. I'm crying, I get that play. Ain't no good going to happen to these people. They can stand up for it. Could be after my death. It got to come down. Y'all hear me? They got to come down. Till you do right by God, everything you touch going to fall. Y'all just like Danny Glover on Color Purple, nigga. We might be poor. We might be black. But thank God we're Yehudians. Isn't that right? I know they say should have kept us locked up. They let us out to cooking and clean. Isn't that right? That's how they treat us. Listen to the book.
There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth.
Come on, son.
When ye shall see Abraham and Isaac and Jacob.
Where they going to be at, son?
And all the prophets.
Where they going to be at?
In the kingdom of God.
And what about you? And tell them where they going to be at.
And you yourselves.
Shall going to be what?
Thrust out.
Ain't going to be no done Christians in no kingdom of God. It's all the prophets. You know what was key for that? Where you land at? The book say you the children of the prophets. Then why you think Moshe told you we're not the Lord that all their people were prophets?
Amen.
The prophets got to get in. Yeah. Y'all hear me? That's why he told y'all in the last day, I'm going to pour out my spirit, said the Lord, upon all who? Right. And your sons and your daughters shall what? Let's say he said all people. But then he said, your sons and your daughters, that cut that off.
Yeah.
Everybody ain't getting it. Now I said, your son, I'm going to pour it out on all people. Reason he said all people, because we've been dispersed into all these different countries. That's not talking about know everybody going to be saved. On all flesh, because we've been dispersed. Some of our people in different countries, in islands. So I'm going to pour out my spirit upon all flesh. But he said, your sons and your daughter shall prophesy. And you prophesy, what are they going to make you? Prophets. Who are going to put it together? They read it, now you have a religion called we the prophet, because we the only folk going to be saved, because you're a retard. Our religion ain't called no the prophets. That's why you got to have a teacher. That's the purpose of him pouring his spirit out upon us. Because they're going to put you under the prophets. When Moshe sat there and he began to talk in the spirit, everybody began to prophesy. Thank the Lord. Come on, son.
And they shall come from the east and from the west and from the north and from the south and shall sit down in the kingdom of God.
Y'all hear that? Now who they going to be? That's us. We're the only people dispersed in all these different winds. We got this. What prophet told us about this? You're right, Ezekiel. He told him to take a razor and let it come upon thy beard, which would have said a sword. They said a barber's razor. What would he be doing? What would they have been doing with a barber and a barber's razor? He'd have took a sharp sword. That's why you have a teacher. You start reading stuff, they had you thinking modernist stuff. Modernization was back then. He took under him a sharp sword. They said barber's razor because they start looking at them being English. They term. They said, for us, we say barber's razor. Which wouldn't have made no sense for them. They were Hebrews. When they said, took a sharp sword and he would have cut it. Some he would have cast into the fire. Some he would have tied in. He told him to bound it inside of his girdle. And the other he told him to blow it, let it go in the wind. Another part he told him to take it and put the sword on it. The part that blew in the wind was that were dispersed. Because when we came out, some of us were burned in the fire. Some of us were killed with the sword. And if some of us were bound, some of us were still there. That's why some of us, he told to take it and bind it. Inside the girdle would mean some stayed there. And the rest of us, he said, throw it in the wind. When it went in the wind, it blew in all directions. I'm a teacher. That's what I do for a living. These people don't know what they're doing. Why do you think he said they're going to come from the east and from the west to the north? Because we in all these different places, we've been dispersed.
Amen.
The wind took us. Some wind everywhere. We ain't have no say, well, we're going to take this. Everybody was dispersed. It wouldn't have made no sense when they'd have taken us to say, we're going to take all Yehudians and take them here. We're going to take all Nefertelis. No, I'm going to take some Yehudians. I'm going to mix it with some Nefertelis. I'm going to mix everybody together. It's dispersion. That way, there's going to be a difference. Think about it. We were put into different regions, different areas, so we're going to speak a little different language from our captors. They learned that from Babylon. Once we understand each other, we can't communicate. Would it make sense to take everybody from Yehuda to one place? No, it don't make sense. It makes absolutely no sense. Because you're going to want to communicate. Y'all speak the same language. Y'all going to know the same thing. Y'all will start reciting things. Y'all start bringing things back in remembrance. I got to put you with some other people ain't been with you. You ain't really got a whole lot to talk about. The way they did, even the slave master had enough sense not to leave everybody on the plantation. When he bought slaves, he wasn't going to buy all of them from the same place and let y'all stay together. Y'all going to start talking. I know you. You used to be around the palm trees. I'll get you around somebody you don't know. Then they later on, they put together and they teach us how to fight each other. They use sporting. You know somebody going to be different to fight somebody you know. Hate somebody you know, I get you to make you fight somebody you don't know. Make you fight somebody you don't know. So now you just automatically build up hatred from one another because you ain't got no communication. You don't have anything in common. Y'all don't see how deceptive slavery was? Slavery is a whole lot deeper than what y'all know. It still got divided. You can have a black church sit right down across the street from my day, same name in Christ, of Christ, in God, of God. We won't even talk. Still say, still going to be with the Lord, in Christ, out, around Christ, up Christ, down Christ. In God, out of God, side God, top God, bottom God. We ain't going to talk, we come out. You know y'all false. Y'all false too. Praise the Lord, see you in heaven. That's how they get you. All you got to do is do some wordplay. Wordplay, get the church of God, church of God actually came from church of God in Christ. They broke off. They said, yep. You know, we're going to be church of God. They decided to change the doctrine. Church of God go along with two and one white, more than one white. Church of God in Christ, you just didn't believe in but one white. Mm-hmm. All the people break, everybody break, and they all, when you root everybody back, they all break from Catholicism. Oh, they're the same thing. They want to pay the Pope. But you still believe the same thing. None of these people are rigid. That's what gets you just sick. They argue with me all the time, and you the one lost. You still on the deceptive slave team. They got you thinking I'm the enemy. They ain't never heard nobody open their book up and show them Lucifer and show you relate to him. Never in their life they ain't heard it. Man, he might be coming, that's the devil. 14, they started, I said, that's the devil. Somebody said, Luda, because they made fools out of us. Same way they got you say, I mean, somebody came and said, you sure? I want to get that out of here. All I know is Jesus. They program up with good time. So they got rid of luck because they know you don't read it, you don't see that black Jesus. Now they start showing you good luck with that Jesus. Then at the end, when Jane and finally finna come up, black Jesus failed them. Then what they say? Put the white one back up there. You know what that sublime to teach you? The nigga gonna fail you, going right back to the white. Little stuff that funny and humorous, they program you. They know some of you read and you investigate. So they show you it looks like luck. Everything happened with luck. Michael done seen the accident, he really ain't seen and got paid. You done deceived them people. Now you watch, that deception came from black Jesus. Huh? Jane done hit the number. Cause of who? Black Jesus. What do y'all think this actual program to tell you? Look at all the acts that happened with them. All the acts that happened with them were luck, gambling. But white Jesus, they were in poverty. Jane's got fired every week. So every episode, I know Jane, he got that pocket barely hang on. Him and Grady Wilson never changed clothes. Nope. Grady wore them same corduroy every show.
Yep.
But Jane never got ahead. Every bonus he got taken. Every job he got before he got there, he got hired. Then the nigga got killed. Who? Blank, blank, blank. White Jesus still on the wall.
Yep.
Bookman put him out. The heat don't work. Yep. The air conditioner stuck. White Jesus still done smile, them niggas. No bad luck with white Jesus. Soon as black Jesus comes, Jane get invested, he get interest on his money. Huh? Michael becomes an investigator. Bad luck. Wrong, deceptive, deceiving. What good luck did they have with white Jesus? Jane left the show behind that white Jesus. Every time you watch that show, you'll look. When they go back there, they always show you that white Jesus.
Yep.
Keep it wrong. Subliminally, they know. Everybody don't watch TV the same. Everybody watch. I'm one of the people I watch. I watch the crowd. One time I just still focus on the people. You watch the crowd, you'll pick up some stuff you don't know. You'll see some people years ago that were crowd people that wound up becoming actors later. Yeah. It's stuff you watch. Guess what? So I got you. See, I know it's some people that's not, so I'm gonna get you with their speakers. You the type, you stay focused on the characters. Good, I'll get you there. I got the others that like the crowd surf. I'm gonna get you on images you're gonna catch. Now, why is Jesus good enough for them and in that show? He's good enough for you. Man, see, these people work the program because everybody ain't the same. You can't use the same tactics on everybody, so you got to use different forms of tactics to capture people. You got to have subliminal messages. Nobody ever paid attention. Behind white Jesus, they never got ahead. Why you going to get ahead? Fred Seven of them had white Jesus. Where they went? Nobody ever got ahead with white Jesus on none of them shows. They all stayed poor, they stayed dumb, and they stayed ignorant. Everything they got, look at Joy, he was just lucky. Wasn't nothing he did with bro. Everything he did was just lucky, just fortunate. Stuff just happened for him. Nothing, they'll never put in the show that we actually made and we did anything. Anything they give us, that look like just time just hit him. Something just happened. That stupid nigga just got a chance. He don't know what he's doing. That's how they program his subliminal messages. I come along and try to break that yoke off because it keeps you from understanding how God works. Watch the show the next time and see it on that show by at some point, and you don't see a white Jesus. When they come over that wall, when you're going toward their kitchen, right when you go down the hall to go to the bathroom, yep, and where they sleep at. I used to want to go back there and look at their bedroom so bad. Because he go back there, then JJ going to go. I said, ain't but two bedrooms. Now, he ain't in there sleeping with them. Or is he? He pulled you, then it was 2 months gone. That one bathroom had a lot of work. Like they had another bathroom down that hall. I just want to walk through myself. I just like to check. I don't believe. How many of y'all would just like to walk down and just check it? I see them show you keep going them door. I be want to know. I didn't know what's going on behind that door back there. Y'all all right? It ain't hard to get to see Thelma room about one or two times. We got some credit. We gonna probably write these folks. Wasn't that Norman Lear? White man wrote every show. Mm. Look at that one. Y'all look at credit. Norman Lear wrote all them shows. No, he stole it. What do he know about black folk living? Right. How white man gonna write a show and laugh for 10, 15 about black folk living struggle? Damn, mate! A white man know we do no stuff like that. No, we don't tell that kind of stuff. What you gonna know about some chitlins? No gun wear somebody black robe. They steal everything from us. Yep. Huh? That boy played Lionel on the Jefferson, the one with the afro. He the one wrote that show. Yep. He wrote a lot of them shows. Norman Lear, you watch all them shows, them old black shows, everyone gonna show Norman Lear. Stole every one of them. That's how they do. They beat you every time and then make a fool out, make you think they done invented something. Because you do the same thing you did in the book. You tell every darn thing you know. Come on, son, I got to get you out through him. Man, that word right, though.
Amen.
I don't know when I preach, I got to tell y'all, natural and spiritual. Come on, son, there's 13 chapters I can get. I'm going to come back, Lord, when the Sabbath night. We need to spend some time on some of this stuff. Because there's too many lies. So I got to dispel all these lies. These folks fight me. Don't realize, I'm not your enemy. I'm not your enemy. He came along and gave you a name that meant something different than what he's telling you now. You need to go back and search. You don't need to check behind me. You need to check behind these people made a fool out of you. Listen to the book.
And behold, there are last which shall be first.
And what else, son?
And there are first which shall be last.
Come on.
The same day there came certain of the Pharisees,
yeah,
saying unto him, get thee out, and depart hence, for Herod will kill thee.
And do what? Come on.
And he said unto them, go ye, and tell that fox.
What happened, son?
Behold, I cast out devils.
And what else, son?
And I do cures today, yeah, and tomorrow.
Y'all hear this? He's on performing today and tomorrow. Come on, son.
And the third day I shall be perfected.
So what happened, son?
Nevertheless.
What you go? Never the what?
Nevertheless.
Never the more?
Nevertheless.
Tell them what you got to do, you sure?
I must walk today.
They better pay attention to what I'm trying to tell them. Well, why are you going to tell me that? What are they going to tell me when he got to walk? I'm in prayer with a black man, tell me he got to walk. That's all we've been doing is walking. Oh, they going to make sense for me because he done told me the 26th chapter book of Viaqua. He told you already, I'm going to walk among you. Why would he tell me, nevertheless, I must walk? These dumb people read it, they don't even know what this means. Why is he telling me he got to walk, Boston? What did he must be the son of God. You got to, I've been walking. That's all he did was walk. He was telling them this because he told you what he got to do. I'm going to walk among them. I'm going to put my tabernacle among you. I'm going to walk among you. So nevertheless, I must do what?
I must walk today.
And what else, son?
And tomorrow.
Tell him why.
And the day following.
Why?
For it cannot be.
And see that? He said it can't be. Then what happened, son?
That a prophet perish out of Jerusalem.
He got to make sure Moshe don't be a liar. He met around, he don't do no walking. Now Moshe going to be a liar. Moshe gave you Bilqua, which means he called. He called to let you know you're going to search the scripture because in them you think you got eternal life. They're talking about me. Huh? The word became flesh and did what? Walked right here among us. That's why he let you know how he got to walk. See, folks saying, they even sang a song, when Jesus walked. They don't even know Elsa say, you so dumb. What are you talking about? He walked. Ain't that what they saying? He walked. Sound like walked to me. I'm going to stay what I know. But who right? First of all, they lying because he ain't watched their sins away. But Jesus, Yeshua walked. Kanye West said he walked. He said Jesus walked, yeah. Jesus probably did walk. That's how you got them flies on your mailbox. Isn't that right about the pine straw? 50 bell for $10. Anybody want to go in here? No, don't worry about it now. Nah. I don't want them to boycott and they take my stuff out of Mason. But anyway, everybody cancel my show. Man, I don't be worried about offending nobody. Everybody got to be offended. That's what's going to make you change. Right. Ain't that right? I defend my own people. That's why we make a change. That's why a lot of y'all can't hear you had to be offended. Ain't that right? You want to offend it, you want to make no changes.
That's right.
Ain't that right?
That's right.
I got to get ready and let y'all go, not because I ran out, because I know, again, that I'm going to let y'all go. Before we go, y'all got to go over some things. Now, I got to make sure y'all know some things before we get ready to go. Genesis. Bereshith. What does it mean? Beginning. How do we spell it? B-E-R-E-S-H-I-T-H. Or T-H. How do we spell it? We spell it B, accent, hyphen. Hyphen, accent. R-E-S-H-I-T. Only you put the H because of pronunciation on the last part of it. So like, don't forget, when English, how they spell, they're going to spell it the way they're going to pronunciate words. But then if it's got an H sound on the back of it, then they're going to put an H, which it actually doesn't. Our consonants don't have the same sounds as theirs, so you can't go with how they do things when you write. Y'all got me? Okay, we got Exodus. Shemoth, how we spell it? S-H-E-X-S-H-E-M-O-T-H. How we gonna spell it? S-H, accent, M-O-T-H. Shemoth, what does that mean? Names. That's what it means for Exodus, it means name. Leviticus. Viroqua, for those of you at home, how we spell it first? Q, R. Hey, I'm back there looking at Alvin. Alvin, like you had an R sound with your mouth. You messed me up. So that's V-A-Y-I-Q-R-A. How we spell it for Hebrew is V, accent, or hyphen. Y-I-Q-R-A. And that means called. He called. He called. Okay, we got Numbers. Bar Mitzvah. You going to be with us? Or are you just trying to get ahead? He trying to get ahead. Old headed nigga, huh? All right, let's spell it. B-E-M-I-D. B-A-R, but Midbar. Now, how we spell it for Hebrew? B, accent, M-I-D-B-A-R. And what does it mean? Wilderness. This is the word for numbers. For those watching in, this is the Hebrew word for it. It means numbers. Okay, we have Deuteronomy. Devarim. How do we spell it? D-E-V-A-R-I-M. For those watching, D-E-V-A-R-I-M. That's how you spell it in English. Hebrew, D, hyphen, accent, V-A-R-I-M. And what does it mean? Words. Isaiah, Yeshia, for the prophet Isaiah, who they call Isaiah. How do we spell it? Y-E-S-H. A-Y-A-H. We got a hyphen? Well, for the A. After the H. After the A, you got a hyphen. For what? Yeshiyah. I had to check on that one. You can do it that way too. Or that's what you want to do. You can say, we can do it that way, or that's what you want to do. Jesse, he saw that. That's what it is. Does it have an accent after the A? Oh, okay. Okay. Jeremiah. Jeremiah. How we spell that? Y-I-R-M-Y-A-H. Jeremiah. Jeremiah. I had another one for y'all. No, Obadiah. Obadiah, let's get rid of O-V-A-D-Y-A-H. It's Obadiah. O-V-A-D-Y-A-H. Obadiah. They spell it Obadiah with the B, but it's actually with the V. V. V as in victory. Yeah, over. Thank you. Somebody already getting it. It's over. Is that right? So that should be O, the letter O, V as in victor, A, D, Y, A, H. We'll check back behind me. That sounds about right. Obadiah. So we'll start looking to use these words. Nineveh. What does it mean? Prophets. How do we spell Nineveh? N E V I. Accent. I M. Nineveh. Somebody said, Kithavim. That means the writings. How we spell Kithavim? K-E-T-U-V. Kithavim. Man, y'all, hold on. What? K. Kithavim. Hold on. K-E-T-H-U-V-I-M. Huh? U-V-I-M. That's the H. What is it with K-E-T-U? Kitha. It's got an H in it. It's got to have a Kithavim has an H in it. Y'all got me on. It does have an H in it. What did you say? K-E-T-H-U. It's got an H in it. It's yes. Y'all throw me off. It should be K-E-T-H. What do you got, Ryan? K-E-T. K-E-T-H. That's what I said. Why you left me out here that long? K-E-T-H-U-V-I-M. U-I-M, sorry, U-I-M. So that's K-E-T-H-U as an umbrella, I-M. Kithavim. Kithavim. Yes, it is an H in it. Because, huh? No V, I-M. U-I-M. Hold on, ain't no M. Hold on, friend. Y'all done missed something else? What y'all done did? Listen, I'm gonna went to the sixth grade. I'm field grasping everything. Should have been K E. Should have been a V. It's a V. Yeah, but no, you did it. It's an A. Well, you know why it's killer? Because you got Tanakh, and Tanakh has the H in it. It's the shorty of. Torah, Nineveh, Kithavim. In front of Kithavim, they took the K-H for Tanakh. So there has to be an H in it. K-E-T-H-U-V-I-M. Kithavim. Kithavim. Huh? You want who? He want Fogo off this. Check it out. What you looking at? Don't you see the K-E-T-H? U, it just got I-M. Who? U-I-M. I did. Somebody asked what happened to the V. Why V-I-M. Kids of him. So write that down. If any changes, we'll check it back out on it. But K-E-T-H-U-V-I-M. Kith of him. That means our writings. To not. That's our law. That's T-A-N-A-K-H. To knock. This is why Tanakh is believed to be the short at first, the T-A standing for the Torah, T-O, the N-A standing for the N-V, and the Ninevims, and the K-H standing for the Kitavim. Y'all got it? That's how they said it came with Tanakh. That's why you use Tanakh. It's supposed to be the shortest for all three, which means, because when you have Tanakh, the reason why they initiate why they're supposed to have done it that way, Tuh for the Torah, not for the Ninevim, and Ka for the Kitavim. Y'all got it? So you know where Tanakh is supposed to originate from. The first three letters in all stand for Torah, Ninevim, Tanakh. Y'all got me? Make sense? So y'all went over it? So what we'll try to do, before we get ready to go, we'll go back over these just so we get kind of constant with them. They become kind of second nature for us, and we learn them. Because anything you don't use, you lose. Y'all remember that? So now Obadiah. O-V-A-D-Y-A-H. Obadiah. Y'all got it? So we'll start introducing in a word or so, and we'll make sure we try to go over it. We'll try to learn it. I think I spelled that correctly. It means the messenger or servant of Yah. Matthiah. M-A-T-T-I-T-Y-A-H, which means gift of God, gift of Yah. That's what Matthiah means, gift of Yah. And Obadiah means messenger of Yah. Okay? So everybody good? Appreciate y'all. That's good, brother. Appreciate y'all. Appreciate y'all coming, okay? Appreciate y'all watching.